हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट सोनेट. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट. ए सोनेट इज अ पोएटिक फॉर्म विच ओरिजिनेटेड एट द कोर्ट ऑफ होली रोमन एम्परर फ्रेडरिक सेकेंड इन पैलर्मो, सिसिली. द 13th सेंचुरी पोइट एंड नोटेरी जियाकोमो डी लेंटिनी इज क्रेडिटेड with the sonnet's invention, and Sicilian school of poets who surrounded him credited with its spread. The term sonnet is derived from the Italian word sonetto, which means a short or little poem. By the 13th century, this word sonnet signified a poem of 14 lines that follows a strict rhyme scheme and specific structure. Conventions associated with the sonnet have evolved over its history. Writers of sonnets are sometimes called sonneteers. As we know that the sonnet was created by Giacomo di Lentini, head of the Sicilian school under Emperor Frederick II, but the most famous early sonneteers in Italy was Petrarch. The structure of a typical Italian sonnet of the time included two parts that together formed a compact form of argument. First, the octave, means starting at lines, forms the proposition which describes a problem or question. It followed by a sestet. Sestet means six lines of the end, which has two tercets that proposes a resolution. Typically, the ninth line initiates what is called the turn or volta, which signals the move from proposition to resolution. The rhyming scheme pattern ABBA for the octave became the standard for the Italian sonnets. For the sestet, there were two different possibilities. The first is CDE, and the second one is CDC. In England, this form of poem was introduced by Thomas Watt and Henry Howard, the Earl of Surrey, in the early 16th century. Their sonnets were chiefly translations from Italian of Petrarch and the French of Ronsard and others. They developed a different rhyming scheme from that of Petrarchan sonnet. The rhyming scheme was ABAB, CDCD, EFEF, and the last one is GG, the couplet, which now characterizes the English sonnet. Their sonnets were first published in Richard Tottel's Songs and Sonnets, better known as Tottel's Miscellany, published in the year 1557. It was, however, Sir Philip Sidney's sequence Astrophel and Stella in the year 1591 that started the English vogue for sonnet sequences. The next two decades saw many sonnet sequences by many other English writers. William Shakespeare was one of them, and he was the most famous English sonneteer, who wrote 154 sonnets in all, in a different form which consists of 14 lines structured as their quatrains, three quatrains and a couplet. The third quatrain generally introduces an unexpected sharp thematic or imagistic turn or volta, but in Shakespearean sonnet, however, the volta usually comes in the couplet and usually summarizes the theme of the poem or introduces a fresh new look at the theme. There is another type of sonnet which we call Spenserian sonnet. A variant on the English form is the Spenserian sonnet, named after Edmund Spenser, in which the rhyme scheme is somewhat different from the earlier ones. It is ABAB, BCBC, CDCD, and the last one is EE. Thank you.